fly on. Yeah. You're on. I can hear myself. Right. I'm really nervous. So I apologise that this could be terrible. There you go. Set the mood just right. Do you like the chalkboard and the chalk effect? Because it's learning, so it's quite cool, isn't it? Yeah. That's the coolest bit. Done. Right, next. I'm really struggling. This is not the show. I'll use this one for. Okay. Right, so I've decided to call this agile learning. I could have called it lean learning. Actually, I don't need to give it a name at all because you don't need to name things for it to be cool. It's just I put a name up and then regretted it afterwards, but I stuck with it. Effectively, this is just a bunch of thoughts from my head that I've gathered over the past few years and I've tried to make sense of them and try to make a kind of pattern and formula up in something a bit more solid. And here I am trying badly to relay that back to you in some way that might make some sense and hopefully is useful, if only just how you deal with me. So what does it say next? Oh yeah, I coined a term. This was last night. I came up with a term called the unspecialist. What it is, I looked back at myself and I thought, do you know what? I'm not really that special. I'm not really.
Very special.
I'm not really a specialist at all. No, it's not just last night. I've gone through this a lot. I think about myself and, do you know what? I'm not really very good at anything. I'm just quite good at lots of things. But I'm not really very good at anything. So I thought, I'm a bit of an unspecialist. A jack of all trades, you might say. And the thing is, it's not without trying, because I've really tried to get good at stuff. I've sat down and I've tried to study really, really hard. And it just doesn't work for me. So it's quite depressing in some ways. And some people are laughing, which is nice. Good, thanks Emily. But it's alright, because I've realised that my specialism is learning. So I've actually found my thing. I know what I'm really good at is I'm quite good at learning. I don't sound like I'm being big-headed, but I am. I'm quite good at learning. Stick that behind and smoke it. And the really good thing about this, I'm trying to make myself feel even better, is that learning is something that's never going to go away. I'm always going to need to learn. So it's the best skill, surely. It's got to be one of the best skills to have. I could spend ages learning a Scala programming language, but if I never need it, I never use it, then it's pointless. Or if next week I need something else, it's a waste for it. So actually, being a good learner is fantastic. And so I've invested a lot of time, especially the last few years, but more recently as well, in getting really good at learning. And this works for me, it might not work for you, but I've got some ideas, things that I've recognised about how I learn that maybe you can use. And I've called it agile learning just because it came to me. So I'll skip a couple of cards. I don't know what the next slide is. Hey, here we go. Learn in an agile style. That's probably a better way of saying agile learning. I use an agile approach, so if you're familiar with agile, which most of us are, I use a kind of an agile approach. I'm not going to spend too long using the word agile, just see how it relates, you'll see it. Okay, so the first thing, it's a cool picture. You can laugh at that, that's all right. So context, this is one of the first things that I think is really, really important, is context. Let's have a look at the next version of this slide. It's just a shot putter, that's all it is. So you were all worried about what was going on there. Some people more worried than others about what was going on there. So this is kind of a tenuous link here, but we're familiar with the three most known forms of learning, the visual, the auditory, and kinesthetic. We've all heard about that, or as I found out last night, there's a fourth one, reading and writing is a fourth one. This is Fleming's idea. And I think actually all those things are valid. So the idea is everybody has something that they think is their best way of learning. I learn better when I see stuff, I learn better when I do stuff, etc. I think the most important thing out of all of that is if the context is there, then learning can happen, whatever works for you. If you haven't got a context, learning probably won't happen at all. So getting the context right and making sure you understand the context is really, really important for you. And because I'm lazy, and this is where the agile comes in, context is provided for me by the real world. So I don't go looking for context, it just happens. And oh, there's some context, I better learn something. Fact, perfect. Match made in heaven. Lazy person. Just waiting till that happens. Next up is need to know. Everybody familiar with this guy? Barry the Baptist from Lock, Stock and Two Smoking Barrels. He says to some guy, he says, you're working on a need to know basis. You know because you need to know. that's what he says, and that's kind of something I take as really, really important. I could learn loads and loads of stuff, and I've got an example of that here, this book, which I saw a few months back, I thought was amazing. This is C-sharp 5 in a nutshell. In a nutshell, right? Look at it, it's 1,048 pages of just a brief introduction to the C-sharp 5 language. Imagine if you wanted to learn C-sharp 5 and be the expert. That's just a nutshell book, so there's another 17 of these to get full detail, right? Now for me, I'm quite a slow reader, but even if you're a fast reader, I think it's going to take a long time to become the C-sharp expert. And then the question is, how much of that can you recall? Probably not a lot. So the way I work is, when I need to know something, then I'm going to find the book and learn it immediately, because my context is there, I can go and dig in and get it straight away. That makes sense? It does to me. Cool. So somebody tweeted this recently. I have no idea who it was, so I can't credit them. Hence that. And I thought it was quite an interesting thing. So learning is the acquisition of knowledge, and this is the key bit. Wisdom is the simplification of it. That's really relevant to me. Is I can spend ages acquiring knowledge, throwing stuff into my head. But what I really, really struggled to do, this is why I was failing in the past, was that I couldn't regurgitate it on demand. I couldn't waste. Use it in a particularly useful way. So what I've tried to do is understand how to put stuff into my head the best way possible. And really, just to summarise the previous two points, what's the next slide? Blank, that's all right, I'll do that. So really, just to summarise the other two points, the first one being about context. If I think of my brain as a filing system, what I want to do is, at the point when I put stuff in, I want to make sure that I tag it correctly. So basically, with context, I have to be absolutely conscious of what that context is. As it goes in, I label it like that. And then when I need that information, it's already indexed and I can find it. That's the way my head works. And the other part is about the need to know. So if I jam-pack loads of things in there, I'll just end up with a queue and I can't tag it quickly. So what I do is I just minimize how much stuff I try and learn. Take in as little as possible. And then you don't have to tag very much. You stick it in, it's nice and simple, nice and clear, and when I need it, it comes back out again. The result of that is, not the next slide, shortly. The result of that is that at the beginning you were laughing at me because I was being a bit down on myself because I wasn't a specialist, I was a young specialist. But the result is actually now I feel really confident that I can go and jump into anything, whatever it is. In fact, I'm about to go and buy this old beat-up van at the weekend that I don't need to fix up and learn how to maintain. I don't care, I'll learn it because I know I can do it. So I've got loads of confidence about the ability for me to pick up the skills I need. And I don't care, I can take on a challenge, which is a really cool thing. I think you'll agree. And I'm going to close on a nice little quote by some guy from the past. He says, start with what's necessary, do what's possible, and suddenly you're doing the impossible. Get inspiration. Love it. Cool. Thank you.